you love me, please don't judge me. Got my hands tied, the power's above me. Don't shoot the messenger, I'm just a puppet here. If you wanna place blame, then look to the puppeteer. Family, fortune, envy, jealousy, privilege, passed on, legacy, secret, sabotage, borderline, felony, suicide, subtract, selfish, pedigree, yeah.
How's it going, everybody? C-RadTV back with another video, and welcome to C-RadTV vlog number 35. So, of course, for today's vlog, I am currently in Bowmanville, Ontario, as today we're heading to the NASCAR Pinty Series race at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park for the eBay Motors 200, the second race of the 2023 Pinty Series season. And actually, when I take a look outside my hotel room, the weather is pretty sunny today, which the weather already today, just by waking up, it's already a massive improvement over what we had at this race 1 year ago when we had that microburst storm hit the track around a year ago at this race, which anyone doesn't know, microburst is pretty much the equivalent of a tornado. Like, it was pretty bad last year. Like, hell, both races last year at Canadian Tire were pretty bad, had bad weather, because last year it was rainy and miserable with the microburst, and then, and then for the Labor Day race, it was just overcast with some misting. So, yeah, this time, no, Mother Nature's cooperating this time today, and we got some pretty sunny weather. So, yeah, getting all packed up, got my camera amp hit shirt on. So yeah, getting all packed up, heading out to the track, because we're not too far away from the track. We're like 15, 20 minutes away from the track. But yeah, getting packed up and getting ready to go and checking out the festivities today. We should be there in time to see the optional shakedown session at the track. But anyway, though, I'll meet y'all in the car.
Man, what a beautiful day for a race, huh?
All right, officially on our way to the track. We got about a 20-minute drive there. We'll see you all there. Let's go. Officially at the track inside the infield. There's the Pinty Series paddock over there, and we're in the middle of the 15-minute optional shakedown right now, as a few cars are making their way back to the paddock area. So yeah, we're about to walk right in and check some stuff out. Oh my lord, there's a Ferrari here. Oh my god, it looks beautiful. This is the one Ferrari F1 cannot destroy. Grazie, ragazzi.
72-28, but he is running 6, so very close.
It looks like the lights are off as they work their way in through. I guess great news just about earlier this weekend at Super Production Challenge.
Whoa, Kevin Wacqua has a different paint scheme this week. It's not the Napa blue and white for once. It's now a black and white car. Still same paint scheme as Napa, but different coloring.
Thank you.
my god, it's the Marshmallow Man from Ghostbusters. I know it's the mascot from Michelin, but what's the difference? There's the final car that's getting to go through inspection going through now. We actually got some skydivers all the way up there. Very hard to see with the sun reflected everything, but they up there. And they all land right there in turn one at the track. Thank you.
there we go.
Allen and Avalon. Moto to Limite HGC Chevrolet number 3. Alex Gaggett. Also from Gatawaki, Quebec, the recap Chevrolet number 92, Dexter Stacy. The Bothwell Acura Ace Hill Dodge number 59. And next, from Rockton Pond, Quebec, the GMIA Chevrolet Canada number 27, Andrew Ranger. Eight, from 20th Quebec, the WeatherTech Bell Air Dodge number 47, L.P. Dumoulin. Seven, from Stainer, Ontario, the Leland GMS RGC Shear Metal Products Chevrolet number 9, Brandon Watson. Six, from Lachine, Quebec, the St. Hubert NTN Quick Chevrolet number 18, Alex Tagliani.
Yeah!
From Grimsby, Ontario, the FBM Delta Bingo D'Souza Reeling Chevrolet number 20, Trenton Watson. From St. Thomas, Ontario, the Castrol M Smart Power CIF Metals Dodge number 17, AJ Yellington. And now we stand your front row, starting second from Senior Stash, Quebec, the Adaptive One Napa Auto Parts Dodge number 74, Kevin Lacroix. And your pole sitter from St. Leonard-Daston, Quebec, the GM Paillet Chevrolet Canada number 96, Marc Antoine Cameron.
Yeah!
eBay Motors Canada, Philippe Deleuze.
On behalf of eBay Motors Canada, I want to share how proud we are to sponsor today's race, the eBay Motors 200 NASCAR Pinty Series, and how happy we are to be here with all you fans today. Keep an eye out for the eBay Motors truck. We're handing out some fantastic giveaways. And after the race, head over to ebay.ca/motors for all of your parts and accessory needs. On behalf of the eBay team, I'm really excited to start this off. And with that said, gentlemen, start your engines!
Thank you.
got another yellow out. Red flag's out. There was a big crash down in turn 5 and then knocked water over the track, so they're drying it up right now. Field stopped all the way in turn 10. So 24 Thomas DeBoe, he had some mechanical issues and he's done for the day. They're repairing that car right now, seeing if there's a chance they can get back out there, but he's probably done. So there's what's left of the 88 after his collision. It's a very hard hit on that car. They're done for the day. Back out now with the red flag cleanup in turn 5 is complete.
Dave Meyer coming to the restart. Matthew Scannell out on his heels. Wait a minute. DJ Kennington will tuck right in the number two spot. One of the drivers running real wide there. It is Matthew Scannell. Big opportunity, however, for Marc-Antoine Camper in the 96 and the 20, and Trayton Lavrovic as they slip through from second and third.
Yeah, I just goes to say I got some great mentors in my life. You know, my dad and my brother, they're never short of giving me some advice, and I really appreciate that. Definitely wouldn't be able to do it without them.
Go celebrate with your team. We'll see you at the podium, Brady. Big smile on his face, Gary. I know you don't come here, but there. Let's face the fans that are down here. They want to see.
Good job, Gary. Yeah.
There's a lot of Gary Clute fans out there. Once your car looked very, very loose towards the end, once you realized you didn't have the winning car, how hard were you cheering for Trayton to catch camera and to make a little bit of fireworks?
I mean, a lot. You know, the car was fast. We gambled. We thought it would go green, or we gambled on it going green. Trayton got a really good pit stop, took four tires, and restarted right behind us, and with 25 to go. So we tried to hold him off as long as we could. Bothwell accurate, Ace Hill, can't thank those guys enough. The car was fast. Just the wrong gamble.
How much fun is it, though, that long green flag run to the finish? And thankfully, we saw the best car able to get up to win. You had the best car for a while, and you were out in front. But as these races go and cycle through, how much fun is it to not have restart after restart, just be able to go out there, elbows up, and drive?
Yeah, I mean, it's good. It's, you know, pure racing. It's good. You're just out there digging on a car that's not handling well, and it's a lot of fun around the CTMP.
It was very clear you had your hands full, Gary, but great job. Third place for Gary Clute. Marc-Antoine Cameron's second place is pretty good, but when you lead at the white flag lap, I know what kind of racer you are. You expect to get the job done. Talk us through that final lap.
Well, our strategy was good. I mean, we took only two
tires.
And at the end, I would say the last three laps, the car was getting a bit loose, and I know Trenton was catching me. He did a great job. I was expecting the move on the inside on 10. After attack, he hit me. And, you know, if you reverse that, I will probably do the same. So it's a young season. We still like many races to go. We'll get back someday.
This is 2 weeks in a row. The driver who finished second had a big smile on their face, even though it got very, very aggressive. We don't always see that, Marc-Antoine. What is different about 2023 that you can be satisfied with second place even after it got so physical?
Well, we know the series is really competitive. I mean, and if we want to achieve and try to win in the second championship in a row, we have to finish and we have to collect some good points. Yes, it's fun to get the checkered flag sometimes, but today was second place, and I'm not 100% sure that we're going to do well the rest of the season and we're going to catch, you know, a few checkered flags.
Well said, Marc-Antoine Cameron. Second place finisher to join us on the podium. Driver the number 96 GMIH Chevrolet, Marc-Antoine Cameron.
Track. There is a sports car race that's still to go, but till 4 p.m. But we're not staying around for that race because we came for the Pinty's race, and that was it.
Lapsovich won.
So yeah, Lapcevic won on the last lap pass. But yeah, we've got a 3.5 hour drive back to my grandma's place. I'll talk to you so when I get back.
Okay, I'm finally back at my grandma's place now. So here's the custom Marc-Antoine Cameron diecast I got signed by Cameron. See his signature right there was car number there signed right on the windshield. So yeah, you know, really nice guy, you know, great he signed the custom diecast. So I got that custom finally signed. You know, really nice car for sure.
Alright, I'm back at my grandma's place now. I've changed some comfy clothes here. So yeah, as you can see, I'm completely fucking burned everywhere from the track. You know, on the forearms, part of my face and my neck. I even got burned on my kneecap, too. All I say is do not show Dan Campbell in the lines that my burnt kneecaps because they might try and eat them. But yeah, you know, it was a really good race at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. Like, it was another example of peak Pinty Series racing, you know. Lapcevic's bump and run on Cameron. That's about the cleanest bump and run you'll ever see. Like, not a whole lot of contact. You know, just moved him straight out of the way, you know, just textbook hard racing, you know. Just, you know, great move by Lapcevic. You know, Lapcevic, he looks like the early contender for the championship this year. Now, whether he has any, whether his reliability remains the same for the car or not is yet to be seen. As, you know, the season's still young, you know, it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. There's still a ways to go until the fall brawl at Delaware in September. But yeah, so far, Lapcevic, he looks like the front runner winning the first two races of the season. And Train gets his first career win on a road course. But yeah, that's also pretty cool. All four Train's wins, I've all seen all four in person now. See, so yeah, and also, what is the deal with fucking White's Corner, aka Turn 10 there? Like, it seems like there's always fucking crazy finishes there in Turn 10. Jesus Christ, there must be a fucking golden horseshoe buried down in Turn 10 when they built Canadian Tire Motorsports Park. Because there's been countless crazy finishes in that turn, you know, with Chase Elliott and Ty Dillon in 2013 in trucks, and Blaney's crossover on Caroga in 2014. Then you also had the battle between Nemechek and Custer in 2016. And then you had Gregson and Todd Gilliland making contact in 2018, opening the door for Justin Haley. And the Pinty Series had its fair share. Like, hell, last year we had LaCroix dumping Gary Clune in that turn to win the race. And then this year, Lapcevic does the bump and run on Cameron. And Lapcevic comes out on top. Like, honestly, when that happened, I thought both of them were going to go around and that was going to open the door for Gary Clune to steal the win. Because at one point I thought Lapcevic was going to go in the grass with Cameron and they were both going to be taken out. But yeah, you know, Cameron, he tried to make it to the end on a long strategy stop, you know, with a few cautions and a red flag break. You know, just a lot of craziness happened, but yeah, just an insane race. You know, just peak Pinty Series racing. Next Pinty Series race I plan to attend is going to be Toronto. It's probably more likely going to be Toronto. It's leaning more toward, yes, I will be at Toronto for the Pinty Series race the same weekend IndyCar comes to town. The IndyCar race, probably not in Toronto. But I am going to, but of course, the next vlog on the channel is going to be in a couple weeks. Multiple vlogs, probably. With the collab effort with Space Mel Ferrari 248, which concludes with the IndyCar race on the streets of Detroit, Michigan. My official return to Detroit. But anyway, though, that'll be coming up in a couple weeks. But yeah, that wraps it up for this vlog. Just, you know, just gonna rest here, watch the All-Star race at North Wilkesboro, see how it goes. But anyway, that'll wrap it up here. That's all I gotta say. Hope everyone has a great day, and I'll see you all whenever I make next. I'm out.